Today we're going to show you how we did a custom installation of lithium batteries in our travel trailer. Stand by for tips and tricks. As we showed you in the previous video, we found a place for the batteries where they won't take up any of our storage space and we won't have to drill through the floor. The only downside is accessibility. It's a bit of a tight spot, so we first need to build some custom shelving.
Today I'm here in our garage because we're almost at the point where we're going to install all this new electronic stuff into the trailer. But first I need to build a couple support structures to actually hold everything in place. You know what they say, measure once, cut twice. That's not what they say. I need this platform to take the least space possible. So I'm measuring just exact the battery. I'm gonna have little sides coming up here to hold them in this way. And then I'm gonna have these things here that I can put this tie down across and hold it in the other way and hold them down when we're going over big bumps. All right, we're ready to make the first cut. Safety first. Well, here it is, our battery shelf. This is what's hopefully gonna put the batteries in that tight little spot underneath our stove. So now I've just gotta go and see if that actually matches up. So Mel and I just went out to the trailer and I'll tell you, we had a heck of a time trying to get them in that little spot. But we figured it out and we have confirmed 100% that everything fits. Perfect. So, one thing we did notice was that sliding the batteries onto the shelf was difficult. So, I don't know if you can see here, but we put tape all along the top to make it nice and smooth, make it easier for us to slide the batteries in and out. I've got all the feet exactly measured out. Yeah, we're good to put this in a little bit more permanently now.
We also want to be able to monitor our power usage, keep the electronics cool, and have a convenient spot for the inverter. So we're building a custom panel too. Now that the shelves are built, we get to the tricky part, installation.
I had a little bit of trouble trying to get the shelf above the drawer, and I was telling Mel about it, and she thinks she might be able to get it, so let's see. All right, so what's your strategy here?
I don't have one. Just do it.
I like that strategy. Look at that. Well, it's a good thing we had Mel available, because now I don't have to trim it like I thought I would. So Mel helped get the inverter shelf in place, and now I just need to level it off a little bit and get the inverter up to the exact height that it'll match on the front panel. I've got these little riser blocks, and they're just gonna go right here and level out the shelf. And then these larger riser blocks are gonna go under the inverter and raise it to the exact height. Fingers crossed. So I'm out in the trailer, it's nighttime. I've got no light and no heat because I've got the converter all ripped out. We're gonna take this battery shelf and get it down into these depths here. And then we're gonna put these batteries on top of it. I've measured it all out, but as we've seen already, you're never 100% sure until you actually start hooking stuff up. Okay, that's step one. So now it's time to install the batteries. And you'll see I've attached the wires already because there's just so little room in there. Normally these wires hanging around would make me pretty nervous, except these are what's called smart batteries. And this little plug here, I've actually put them into shelf mode, which means they won't give any current. So even if I cross these wires or, you know, touched up against a ground or something, no problem. Confident that my batteries are still in shelf mode. Very little room to go in here. The project's coming along very nicely. I've got the charge controller all set up here. I've got, you know, all the wiring roughed in, fuses. I just have to make two more wires and hook them up and should be in business. Oh, look at that. There's my monitor, 13.3 volts. Now let's see if we're hooked up to the trailer correctly. Hey, hey. Did it just get a little brighter in here? Apparently those lights take about 1.2 amps. You can probably hear the whine of the converter fan here. Everything appears to be working. The battery is charging at a rate of about 45 amps, which isn't bad. Converter's going. Trailer has power. Not bad. It's 11 p.m. The converter is all back in place. Everything is all secured and hooked up. This job didn't actually take as long as I thought, but there was two sort of minor what could have been disasters, I'll say. One is when I turned on the converter for the first time. I got a spark, and that scared the crap out of me. So I immediately turned it off, texted my brother, told him what happened. He walked me through the whole circuit, checking for things that might be shorted. It looked okay, so turned it on again. It sparked a little bit again. Apparently, that's just what can happen. We just never saw it or heard it before because it was behind this panel. I don't know. If you know something about this, please let me know in the comments. So the second thing was, all right, we've got battery hooked up, everything's working great, except the slide is not working and the tongue jack is not working. Why are they not working? So again, I had to consult my brother, who's a bit of an electronics expert. We're going through the whole circuit, we're tracing everything, we're checking voltages at certain spots. At one point I'm like, okay, well the wire now just goes down through a hole in the trailer. So I don't really know exactly where it goes from there. He's like, okay, well it probably goes to some kind of bus, you know, there's probably a fuse or something. And immediately, ding, a light goes off in my head. 3 days ago when I started this project, I pulled the external emergency battery cutoff. Do you think that I had turned that back on again? No. Duh. It's pouring rain outside. I've got to go out, go around, push in the disconnect, come back in, turn everything on. It all works perfectly. So thank you to my brother who talked me through it all and reminded me that I had not turned it back on. What a fail. But these are the kind of things that you learn as you do a project like this. It's just those little things that you forget, right? All is well, all is good. We've got a brand new battery system and we're going to be able to boondock a lot longer than we were able to before.
So far, so good. Stay with the channel as we upgrade further, including installing solar panels and a high amperage truck charging cable. And we are always very thankful when you take the time to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. It helps us reach more viewers just like you. Thank you. And in the meantime, keep on living the life you've imagined.
So, had a little bit of trouble trying to get the drawer. Oh, wait. So, we're coming along here with the inverter shelf. Yeah, I can see my breath a little bit.